At 4:42 p.m. local time on August 8, 2024, a major magnitude 7.1 earthquake struck 3 miles or 5 kilometers offshore of Japan's southeastern coastline. This generated tsunami warnings for much of southeastern Japan, and now there is even an apparent alert that a far larger earthquake, reading as an 8 or 9, could soon follow. Yet, before I cover the damage which occurred, I want to note that this warning that a larger earthquake could occur, and the keyword in this is could and not probably occur or will occur, is regardless somewhat misleading. It is true that worldwide, between 5 and 10% of earthquakes that strike mark foreshocks which occur before larger magnitude earthquakes, and that these larger magnitude events generally occur within the 7 days following a foreshock. Yet, there is currently no scientific method to predict earthquakes as it currently can't be done, so instead, this warning is more of a notice that, technically speaking, there is an increased chance of a magnitude 8 or 9 earthquake occurring in the same subduction zone than there otherwise would have been if the 7.1 earthquake had not struck. And this is true, but it is difficult to tell how much these chances have temporarily increased. Today's event was a megathrust earthquake caused by stress building on the overlying Amurrian plate, which was being pulled downwards into the mantle via friction through the subducting Philippine Sea plate. This stress built up until it overcame the friction being applied to it, causing what was likely around a 50 kilometer long portion of the Amurrian plate to snap back upwards and generate a minor tsunami. The fear is that today's quake could technically place enough additional stress on one or both regions deemed to be at high risk for producing a magnitude 8+ earthquake sometime in the next 125 years. These major earthquakes are known as Nankai megathrust earthquakes, and ignoring doublet events and large aftershocks which occurred, have happened between 90 and 203 years apart from one another since the year 600. I decided to look at all 139 magnitude 7 or larger earthquakes which have struck Japan at shallow or intermediate depths since 1900. Of these, only 4 of them, or 2.9%, represented foreshocks that occurred within 7 days before a larger earthquake. There is a bit of sampling bias, however, because one of these 4 instances was followed by the devastating 9.1 earthquake in 2011. Yet, 9 magnitude 7 subduction zone related earthquakes have occurred since then, none of which were followed by larger quakes within a week's time. With this out of the way, let us now focus on the damage and hazards today's 7.1 quake generated. This earthquake created strong shaking which lasted for approximately 21 seconds, creating ground acceleration reaching upwards of 20% the force of gravity in some areas. While this did knock items off of shelves and move some heavy furniture, especially in Miyazaki, social media footage suggests that only a single house was knocked off of its foundations. If this marked the most severe damage the 7.1 quake generated, it would be consistent with the lower end of the U.S. Geological Survey's damage model, which suggests an 80% chance that between $2 and $500 million U.S. dollars in damage was caused. 9 injuries were also reported, and while tsunami waves were generated, they were quite small, only reaching a maximum height of 0.43 meters or 1.4 feet. However, my main concern is that widespread liquefaction may have occurred in these highlighted regions, although there is no immediate evidence to substantiate this. Statistically speaking, dozens of aftershocks large enough to be felt are likely to occur across the next month, the largest of which is likely to be around a magnitude 5.9.